grandchildren in our next chapter, which is called Jugs and Mugs. We are going to study about the capacity of the containers. We have already done this in class 3 as well as in class 2. So capacity is the amount of liquid which can be filled in a container. And you know that the unit of capacity is liters and milliliters. We have already studied it. In 1 liter, there are 1000 milliliters. It means 1 liter of liquid, when you divide it into 1000 equal parts, so one part will be 1 milliliter. Children, you can see I have collected so many bottles, and in these bottles different amounts can fit in. Okay, this is a very, very familiar bottle. We use it in the refrigerator for keeping water, and exactly 1 liter can fit in this, right? Now, this is a refined oil bottle, and it has got 2 liters of refined oil in it. So double the amount of the water which is there in this. So if I want to fill this with water when it gets empty, 2 bottles like this can be filled, can be used to fill up 1 container like this. It can contain 2 liters of refined oil or 2 liters of liquid. Now, same is the case with this. This detergent in this bottle. Now you see, beta, the shape of these 2 bottles is different. But this also can contain 2 liters, and this also can contain 2 liters, right? Okay, now I will show you this shampoo bottle. It is written 650 milliliters. So you know, 1 liter is 1000 milliliters. So 650 milliliters is less than 1 liter, but more than half a liter. Yes, because half a liter is 500 milliliters, and this is 650 milliliters. Okay, and this hand wash, on this bottle it is written 500 milliliters. It means half a liter of hand wash or half a liter of liquid can be filled in this. So children, same way, these are some little pouch. This is a tetra pack, and in this tetra pack only 180 milliliter of shake can fit in. Same way, in this juice bottle 400 milliliter of juice can fit in. So beta, this is a measuring mug. You can see that it has got these equal divisions. This is 100 milliliter, this is 200 milliliter, 300 milliliter, 400 milliliter, 500 milliliter, 600, 700, 800, 900, and 1000 milliliter. It means till here, if you fill up the water, it is 1000 milliliter or 1 liter. So this is a mug to measure liquid. Now in your book, we have been given an activity to make a measuring bottle. So you have been told to take 1 liter bottle, and in that 1 liter bottle, you have to fill up 100 milliliter of water and see the level and mark that level. And like that, you will keep on adding 100 milliliter water again and again, and keep on making the markings of 200 milliliter, 300 milliliter, 400 milliliter, and so on. So come, let's do that activity and we always love activity, and with the help of these activities we come to know how actually is 100 milliliter, how much is 500 milliliter and how much is 1 liter. Chalo, let's do the activity now. Children, for this activity we need a 1 liter bottle. It can be a 1 liter water bottle which is easily available. I have taken a 100 milliliter medicine bottle. It is written 100 milliliter on it. Also, I have taken a permanent marker. This marker will be used to put markings on the big bottle. And I have taken this mug in which I have taken water, in which I have mixed Rooh Afza so that the water becomes reddish or pinkish in color, so that you are able to see the water level clearly. Okay, now I will fill up this water, this bottle with 100 milliliter water. So 100 milliliter water is there in this bottle. Now I know that the water is 100 milliliter in this. I am going to pour this water in the big bottle. Okay, now children, you can see that the level of water in the bottle is still here, and this is 100 milliliter. So what I will do, I will, with the help of my pen, very very carefully I will mark, and this will be 100 milliliter water. Let me show it to you. See, this is 100 milliliter water. Okay, this is the way I am going to keep on adding and keep on marking. I will show you one more time how I am going to mark. This is another 100 milliliter of water which I am going to add in the bottle now. Now you can see it is almost double the height. The level, water level, is almost double of the previous level. Very carefully again I will mark the water level with the help of the permanent marker like this. One more bottle, small bottle of water I have poured in this, and now this is beta 300 ml. This was 100 ml, 200 ml, 300 ml. Okay, now again I am going to pour and show it to you. See children, now it is 400 ml. 100, 200, 300, 400 ml. I will pour one more bottle, this small bottle of water, in this, and it will become half a liter. 500 ml is half a liter. I'll just show you. Now see children, I have also started writing the numbers along with it. 100 milliliter, 200 milliliter, 300 milliliter, 400 milliliter and 500 milliliter. Like this, I will keep on adding water from this bottle and keep on marking so that my whole bottle gets marked. Now I will do it finally and show it to you. So children, I kept pouring this bottle full of water in the big bottle and kept marking. So this is my 600 milliliter, 700 milliliter, 800 milliliter, 900 milliliter and 1000 milliliter or 1 liter. And the distance between these two divisions is different from the distance between these two divisions. That is because of the shape of the bottle, beta. It is tapering. It is tapering towards the bottleneck, and here it is broad. So that is the reason it, the distance between these two divisions is different. So this is how we can make a measuring bottle with the help of a small bottle. And I request all of you children to do this activity at home. It is a lot of fun doing this activity, and you will understand how much is the water contained in the bottle. So you will get a very fair idea of the capacity. That's all for today, children. Enjoy your activity and you must do it. Thank you and have a nice day.